So please lift up your hands unto the Lord. Adore the King of glory. Adore the one that came, that died for your sins. Adore that baby Jesus, the one that was born, that ruled just because of you. Amen. You are going to tell the Lord, you are going to say, Father, Father, every benefit of this season, let it belong to me, O God. Deliver it into my hands today.
Deliver it into my hands.
Is somebody praying?
Father,
every benefit of this season,
all the blessings attached to this season,
Lord, please deliver to my hands today.
In the
mighty name of Jesus.
All the blessings, all the benefits, all the healings, all the breakthroughs, all the deliverances of this season, let them not elude me and my family in the name of Jesus. We shall be beneficiaries in the name of Jesus.
Your name, Lord.
Father,
in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Once again, Father, we want to bless your name this morning. Lord, we want to thank you because you have decided to leave your throne, even to die for us here. Thank you, Father, for the wonderful gift of Jesus that you have given unto us. Thank you because the whole world is celebrating this special gift today. Be thou lifted up in the name of Jesus. Father, we are here to be touched by you. We are asking as we go into your words, please minister unto us in the name of Jesus. We pray that all the blessings of this season will be delivered into our hands in the name of Jesus. By the time we shall be leaving this place today, we ask, O God, that both sinking miracles you will give unto us in the name of Jesus. For everybody that can say a louder amen, that Lord, we give you both sinking miracle in the name of Jesus. Father, we appreciate you. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Praise the name of the Lord. And before you sit down, you are going to go to your friends and tell them Merry Christmas, compliments of the season. Wish them a very Merry Christmas. Make sure you are smiling. Make sure you are smiling. Make sure you are smiling. Wish them a Merry Christmas. And you may please be seated. Engineer, please, can you locate my voice? And praise the name of the Lord. I'd like to wish you a very Merry Christmas. And I want to say that the celebration of the birth of Jesus with bad signs, wonders, miracles into your lives in the name of Jesus. If you believe that, say a loud amen. If you believe that, say a louder amen. Praise the name of the Lord. And I want to pray that we shall celebrate many more of this in the name of Jesus. Before we go into the words of God, as a way of emphasis, it has been announced to us that come Tuesday, 26th of December, there's going to be a special Christmas service in this auditorium. I thought somebody would be excited about that. Special Christmas service by 8 a.m. Tuesday, 26th of December. I don't know where else you can be if you are not here. So please announce to your friends, tell everybody that God is set to bless every one of us this season. God is bringing unto us special gifts. And make sure you come to receive your own in the name of Jesus. And also, for our own parish here, Trinity Sanctuary, starting from Thursday, 28th of December, to Saturday, 38th of December, we shall be having a special end of the year service that will be starting by 4:30 in the evening. I'd like you to know that as the year is passing by like this, there are miracles that God will be sending his angels to give unto people. So once you present yourself, you'll be sure that you'll be a partaker of these blessings. And the title is All Round Victory. There is somebody here this morning, because you are here, and by the grace of God, because you'll be in that program, All Round Victory shall be your portion in the name of Jesus. Shall be your portion in the name of Jesus. Engineer, can you please raise it higher? I'm stressing my voice here. Thank you. God bless you. Praise the name of the Lord. And on Sunday, that is the coming Sunday, that is going to be our crossover night. I am crossing over to victory. I'm crossing over to signs and wonders. I'm crossing over to the new year. There is somebody here. Together, we are going to shout Happy New Year. Yeah. Only few people believe that. We are shouting Happy New Year together. No matter what the enemy does, you will see the new year. I said you will see the new year. Praise the Lord. So make sure you get yourself ready for all of this program so that we can lay good foundation for the coming year. And God will bless us in Jesus' name. And very briefly this morning, before we close, we shall be looking at a topic that says, do not wash your net yet. Tell somebody, my brother, my sister, don't wash your net yet. You are saying it as if you don't believe it. Don't wash your net yet. Praise the name of the Lord. And tell your friend, it is not over yet. Do we have the youth in this house? Do we have the youth in this house? If you're a youth, can you lift your hand and let me see you? So can you please help me to tell people or teach people how to say this? Don't wash your nets yet. Hallelujah. Can you please turn your Bible to the book of Luke chapter 5? Our text is taken from the book of Luke chapter 5, verse 1 to 11. But for the want of time, we are going to take a few verses. 1 to 11. You can just write 1 to 11. But for want of time, we are going to read together verse 1 to 4. And it came to pass that, please, if you have your Bible, please read. Let's read it together. Read it out. 1, 2, go. And it came to pass that, as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Genesaret and saw two ships standing by the lake, but the fishermen were gone out of them and were washing their nets. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. Now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your net for a drought. Let's take the next verse, and that will be the last one. Want to go? And Simon answering said unto him, Master, praise the name of the Lord. There is somebody here this morning. Because you are here and you are going to be obedient to the words of the Lord, every of your hanging benefits shall be delivered into your lives in the name of Jesus. Where we have read is just a story that should encourage anybody. And I want you to know that God has not finished with you yet. In fact, God is about to start with you. In fact, God has just started with you. And by the time God finishes with you, your friends, your family members, everybody that knows you will see you and they will give glory to the name of the Lord. If you believe that, say a loud amen. In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9, the Bible says, what ears have not heard, what eye has not seen, nor the ear has heard, or what has not entered into the minds of man, into the heart of man. These are the things that God has prepared for his people. And I know you are part of his people. You are the child of God. So things that will marvel your enemy, the Lord will do for you in the name of Jesus. Before the end of this year, you are going to sing a new song. The song of joy. The song of miracle. In the name of Jesus. Beloved, I'd like you to know that you are right in the center of God's plan. And if we go back to our text, you will see what God can do. And before we move further, I will just tell you two stories. I just want to tell you two stories. One is a personal story. The other one is a story that just happened to a brother last week. Just to tell you that no matter what the calendar is reading, no matter what is happening all around you, God may decide to turn your life around. And for somebody here, under the sound of my voice this morning, God will turn your life around. I said, God will turn around your life for the better. In the mighty name of Jesus. In year 2010, I was in a desperate need of a particular miracle. And, you know, I had believed God for this particular miracle throughout the year. From January to March to June to August to September and to December. And like we announced to you, it was announced that for the end of the year that we shall be having a program, 3 days program to be precise. In fact, as I was looking at it, it fell on the day we have announced to you, 28, 29, 30. And so we began the program. And on the 28th, the man of God said that God was telling him that there were some people that were still going to get their special miracle. And of course, he raised a sacrificial offering, very huge to some people. But I just kicked myself in and I sold. Don't get me wrong, I'm not raising any offering here. And I sowed sacrificially. In fact, I could remember vividly, he said we should raise our handset and he prayed that you are going to hear, you are going to receive the call that your destiny is waiting for. Some people keep, many people keyed into it. To be precise, on the second day, that was 29th of December, 2010. I received the call. What's a particular thing that I've submitted since January? And he now called are we talking to so-so? And so I said, yes. That we've been trying to reach you for the past 3 months. We've written a letter in your name. Why haven't you come to receive it? I said, I don't know. You have my contact. You have everything. They said, the man said that before, because they were closing for the year, that before he leave that day, that he just wanted to do the last trial, the last trial. And by January, by the end of that December, it will have lapsed. And I said, wow, this is God. And I told the man I was interested, that come January 2nd, I would come to the office. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. What am I saying in essence? Somebody may feel that, oh, just 2 days, 29, 30, 31st, 2 days to the end of the year, what else can I receive again from the Lord? But I am a living witness. God did it, and it was a very, very big miracle. For somebody that is ready to key into this today, I declare into your life, God will come big for you in Jesus' name. That miracle you have been believing God for several years, before the end of this year, God will give unto you in the name of Jesus. You are coming back here to give your testimony. I said you will give your testimony. If you believe this, say a better amen. The second one that I said I want to share with us, just last week, somebody wanted to sell a car. And my brother-in-law was a go-between. And he told me, Mom, brother so-and-so is interested in this car. I said, I didn't say it, but I was thinking in my heart, where will he get money? Because I know him sincerely. Miracle that will surprise your pastor. God will give unto you in the name of Jesus. I know the brother very well, sincerely. And I was thinking, where would he get the money? So 2 days after, my brother-in-law said, Mom, he has paid. And we're talking of more than a million naira. I said, he has paid. I now asked him, how come? He said, Mom, that was the question I was asking myself. And my brother-in-law told me that, could you believe that as of September, my wife and I, we were still giving this family food stuff. And my brother-in-law is not so rich. In fact, he doesn't even have a car. And to tell you, he was the one driving this brother's car. I said, I'll go and deliver the car to the owner. He said, he doesn't know how to drive. He's just learning. I stand to pray for you. Whatever you have even forgotten, that you even feel cannot happen again in your life before the end of this year, God will come be for you in the name of Jesus. And my brother-in-law told me that, Mom, God just bless him. He just won a contract. And before the end of this year, this brother is moving to his house, a four-bedroom apartment, all en suite. That is what God can do. I said, that is what God can do. We are serving a miracle-working God. He can decide to come big in your life. He can decide to manifest his power in your life only if you can believe. Praise the name of the Lord. So when we look at the story that we have here, there are five basic lessons that I quickly want to bring to our attention. Praise the name of the Lord. In this story, Luke chapter 5, I want to quickly point out our attention to five basic lessons. Number one, I want you to know that Jesus is aware of whatever situation you are passing through. There are so many of us. Our song is, maybe God has forgotten me. Maybe God does not even care about me. Maybe I'm meaningless before God. Brethren, I'd like you to know that God has not forgotten you. Look at these people. By the time Jesus got to the lakeside of Gennesaret, you know when he got there, he was not talking about their fishing. He was not looking at their side. He just went straight to preach. And he just requested for their boats. Of course, he knew what they were passing through. Of course, he knew what they had passed through. Of course, he knew that they had toiled all the night and they had got nothing. Because the Bible says it's the Alpha and the Omega. It's the beginning and the ending. It was there in the beginning with God. Praise the name of the Lord. So whatever you are passing through, my brother and my sister, Jesus knows about it. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews chapter 4 verse 15, Hebrews chapter 4 verse 15, the Bible says, for we have not an high priest which cannot be touched by the feeling of our infirmities, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. Whatever you are going through that may make you to want to decide to throw in the throwaway, whatever you are passing through that may make you to want to say that of what use, I don't want to try again, I'm even tired, I have tried, nothing is working, I want you to know that Jesus is aware of it. Tell somebody Jesus is aware of it. Is it rejection? Jesus was rejected by his own people. The Bible says he came unto his own, and his own, they don't believe him. So what is it that you are passing through? You've been rejected by friends? Jesus passed through it. Is it poverty? The Bible says concerning Jesus that he became poor so that you can be rich. So what is it you are passing through? Jesus has gone ahead of you. Is it betrayal? Look at Jesus. One of the people he trusted so much was the one that betrayed him. That was a person that sold him out to the enemies. So don't be discouraged. Are there aspirations that you set out in January that have not yet come true? Are there contracts that maybe you submitted your proposal for, but as you speak, as we talk, you have not got anything from it? And the devil is telling you, look at you, look at your life. You've been praying. What have you got to show for it? I want you to know that Jesus knows about it. There is in one of our hymns, it says, Jesus knows all about our struggles. He will guide till the day is done. There is no other friend like an only Jesus. No. Brethren, whatever challenge you are passing through, Jesus knows about it. He was aware of their challenge, and at the end of the day, they had testimony. You will have your own testimony. Number two, every challenge you go through in life is a test. Every challenge that you go through as a child of God, as a child of God that is in the will of God, as a child of God that is always running away from sin, it is a test of your faith. You don't know where God is taking you to, but at one point or the other in your life, God may allow you to pass through a particular challenge, a particular trial, in order to test your faith. We have a good example in the life of Job, chapter 1. Job, chapter 1. From verse 6 to 12, you will see the account of Job here. And the enemy was challenging God because of Job. In order to test something in the life of Job. And at the end of the day, Job had to go through a lot in his journey in life. I don't know what you are going through as we sit down. I don't know whether, even if you go back home, you don't even have anything to eat. But God knows about it. God is going to change your story. I said God is going to change your story. God is going to come big for you. In the name of Jesus. Look at the devil. The devil was telling God, why won't Job fear you? You have built a hedge around him. You try and test him and see if he will not curse you. But heaven was rejoicing because of Job. God was standing in for Job. God was saying, no, many people can deny me. Job can never deny me. At the end of the day, the Lord helped Job. God that helped Job will help you. I said it will help you. Also look at the life of Peter. Peter too was undergoing a test by all the hard that were happening unto him at the lakeside. But thank God, at the end of the day, Peter passed. For every test of life that will come your way, you will pass in the mighty name of Jesus. You will pass in the name of Jesus. Number three, every challenge you go through in life is a training process. Every challenge that you go through in life is a training process. From the foundation of the earth, God knows that Peter was ordained to lead his disciples. So he needed a period of training. Jesus was training his ability to persevere. Jesus was training his ability to be patient in the face of trials. Because if you are going to be the leader, if you are going to be at the forefront, if you are going to direct other people, there are some qualities that you must possess. So when you look at Peter, God was taking him through all of these processes. If you don't believe that, what about the life of Joseph? Look at the life of Joseph. Joseph was meant for the top. Joseph was meant even to lead a whole country and even other countries all around them. And because of this, he went through different stages. I don't need the stage of life that you are going through now. But one thing that I'm sure of is that God will come big for you in the name of Jesus. At the end of the day, Joseph got to his destination. You will also arrive. You will arrive at your destination in the mighty name of Jesus. Number four, your disappointments are heaven's applaud. Your disappointments, whatever you feel are your own disappointments, these are things that are making heaven to rejoice, so be clapping for you. When God helped Job to stand, heavens were clapping for Job. And I also want you to know that your disappointment is God's appointment for a divine turnaround. When you feel you are disappointed, that is when God is stepping into your situation. That is when God is causing a turnaround in your life. And I am believing God for somebody. Every disappointment you have ever had in life will combine to turn to miracles for you in the name of Jesus. And because of our time, number five, when you get involved in God's business, your business can never suffer. Look at Peter. When Jesus got there, he said, let me just have your boats. I need to preach. These people are pressing too hard on me. Let me just thrust out and sit so that I can face them and they can hear the word. Peter did not look at his disappointment. Peter did not say, my boat for what? They call you a miracle worker. Can't you do the miracle in my life? What did Peter do? He surrendered his boat. He surrendered his boat. Whenever you are involved in God's business, your home business can never suffer. We have the case of Elijah in the Bible. 1 Kings chapter 17. 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 10 to 16. The Lord sent Elijah to Zarephath. By the time he got to Zarephath, he met a widow. Maybe he was thinking in his heart, how can this widow sustain me? This widow can never sustain herself. But Elijah told the widow, go and get me water. That woman was, of course, for that woman to even agree to give him water was an heart of, was a very good heart. Because at that time, there was famine, there was drought, everywhere was dry. So water was an essential commodity. As if that was not enough, the woman was going, and this man of God said, come back, please, had a little cake. And the woman voiced out, man of God, evil God knows I don't have that. The little that was remaining was meant for my child and myself to eat and die. But the man of God said, don't worry. Go and do as I have told you. At the end of the day, we know what happened to this woman. Because she believed the man of God, and she did that, God was involved in her situation. Likewise, Peter, when he did the bidding of the Lord Jesus Christ, he never suffered again. He caught drought of fishes. For somebody that is here, as you are going to believe and hand over unto the Lord and do his bidding, no more suffering will be mentioned in your generation in the name of Jesus. I said, no more suffering in the name of Jesus. This is the time of let's go out fishing. Many people will say, this is the time that business is booming. I don't want to go. But it's better for you to leave something and get involved in the business of God. People that are wise are the people that are investing in the kingdom project. People that are wise are the people that are involved in whatever belongs to God. There is no way by which you will do that of God, and God will not be responsible unto you. Praise the name of the Lord. So my brethren, I want you to know that it is never the wish of God for you to be washing your nets now. God does not want you to be in the valley of hopelessness, in the valley of depression, in the valley of despair, like Peter. Peter, before he obeyed, he told the Lord Jesus, what else can we do? We just have to accept our faith. We have to go back home. Because your nets are meant to catch fishes. And they will catch many of them in the mighty name of Jesus. Instead of you washing your nets, few things you have to do, and we begin to pray. Number one, instead of washing your nets, these are the things you need to do. Number one, Jesus is in need of your boats. It may not be a physical boat as we speak, but it's in need of the boat of your heart. Proverbs chapter 23, verse 26. Proverbs 23, 26. The Bible says, my son, give me your heart. There are some of us, we are just playing church. There are some of us, we've stayed so long in the church, we don't even know the meaning of being born again. But we are rounding off a year, preparing to go to another year. If you are part of the people that are playing church, this is a very good opportunity for you to give him your heart, to surrender all. Look at Peter, a very good example for us. He was involved by himself. Throughout the night, Jesus was not part of that business. Jesus was not part of that game. So he was doing it with his own effort, with his own power. At the end of the day, he caught nothing. So, this is the time to surrender our hearts, everything unto God. Number two, look out for Jesus and do his biddings. Enough of complaints. Like Peter, this is the time for you to connect with Jesus. Go all out for Jesus. Many of us in our journey, in our Christian journey, we are not fervent again. We are complaining, we are complaining. When you connect with the Lord Jesus Christ, he's going to order your steps. He ordered the steps of Peter. Was it not the same ocean that Peter and his friends had been fishing all night? Just a word by the Lord Jesus Christ changed the whole story. I stand to declare into the life of somebody today, God will give you a word your destiny is waiting for in the name of Jesus. Amen. A word that will change your destiny. The Lord will release it into your life today in the name of Jesus. Amen. Jesus just told him, launch out into the deep. The same deep, the same ocean that they had walked throughout the night. For several hours they were there, they caught nothing. But because they listened to Jesus, they followed the instruction of Jesus, Peter did not change his net. By the time he got the miracle, he didn't change his net. He didn't change his boat. He didn't change his friends, the business partners. He didn't change his location. He didn't go to another ocean. The same place, the same net, the same boat, the same business associate that were not fruitful before, now became fruitful. I am speaking to your life that as you surrender all and you connect to Jesus, there will be a divine turnaround in your life in the name of Jesus. Number four, don't lose hope, just obey. And number five, believe that he's preparing an amazing testimonies for you. Matthew 19:26 says, all things are possible. How many things? One thing, two things, just three. The Bible says, all things are possible to that man that believes, to that woman that believes, to that child that believes. Brethren, I am here to tell you, because God has done it for me before, that your nets can still catch drought of fishes. Praise the name of the Lord. Say, my net will still catch fishes. Not one kind of fish, but different kinds. Different kinds. And because you are here this morning, boat sinking miracle, God will give unto you in the name of Jesus. I'd like you to please stand on your feet if you believe this. As you are standing, say, my net will still catch fishes. If you say it as if you believe it, my net will still catch fishes. Let's lift up our hands and we sing this song. It's like you are praying. I believe, yes, Lord, I believe it is well with me. I believe, yes, Lord, I believe, yes. Church knows this song. So I'd like you to please lift up your hands unto the Lord. Close your eyes and sing along with us.
Yes, Lord, I
God is making me to see the heart of some people here. those hearts are filled with bitterness. Bitterness. God, what have you done? That's okay, choir. God, what have you done? There's nothing to show for it. That is what that heart is saying. But God wants you to drop that at his altar this morning. Because if your heart is still saying this, you cannot receive anything. The Bible says a double-minded person cannot receive anything from the Lord. Lift up your hands unto the Lord and say, Father. Is that all you can do? Father, I believe. Let there be a divine turnaround in my life before the end of this year. Is that all you can do? Is that as much prayer you can say? In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. What is that special desire? That miracle that you even feel cannot even happen again. It is so big, but God can do it. And the word is saying you should not wash your net now. Don't wash it yet. So I want you to open your mouth and tell the Lord that particular miracle. You know it, I don't know it. So ask the Lord, Father, before the end of this year, you have done it for some people. I've heard your testimony. You can still do it for me. This is my request. Are you praying? You have just 1 minute. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. There is one last prayer point we're taking. I don't know the owner of this gift. I can see it. Big gift, wrapped. And they are still looking for the owner. It depends on how you can pray. You are going to say, you are going to shout, you are going to pray, you are going to tell the Lord. You are going to tell the Lord, Father, Father, my special Christmas gift, deliver to my hands, deliver to my hands, deliver to my hands, deliver to my hands. Ah, only one gift is what I am seeing. I am not lying. I can see very big. I don't know who is going to take it. Sekiri Baba. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Because you have prayed this morning, that special miracle that your destiny is waiting for, receive it in the name of Jesus. Every hopeless situation in your life, because God has helped you to be in church this morning, I command this return to be awful in the name of Jesus. Every garment of shame in your life, because you are here this morning, God is changing it in the name of Jesus. In place of shame, God is putting onto you garment of honor in the name of Jesus. I declare that boat of your life will catch drought of fishes in the name of Jesus. that your certificate will attract attention in the name of Jesus. That your business will still flourish before the end of this year in the name of Jesus. Every proposal you have submitted that has not yielded anything, before the end of this year, you will receive wonderful calls in the name of Jesus. The Lord will come big in your life. The Lord will show up in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. And we have testimony. We are still praying. If you are in church this morning and you have not given your life to Jesus, everything we have said is not meant for you, because these people, they were disciples of Jesus. Though as at that time, they were not really following full time, but they were disciples. For God to enter into the boat of your life, for God to cause drought of fishes to enter into the net of your life, you must connect with him. You want to say, Father, I connect with you this morning. I surrender everything. The one that I've been doing myself, what have I caught? I surrender everything to you this morning. Wherever you are, please, can you lift up your hands unto the Lord, and I pray with you. You may have been coming to church. That is not what I'm saying. If you have not truly given your life to Jesus, when you go out of church, you still have one thing or the other you do. You still have places you go. God wants you to put an end to all of this. He wants you to say, Lord, I surrender everything and everything. You want to give your life to Jesus wherever you are? Please lift your hand before the final prayer. I believe, yes, Lord, I believe.